bad, but the Lord forgave me. And I said, Lord, give me another chance. And I've been getting chance after chance. And the people have been receiving me because, you know, when you say, oh, I'm going to pray for you, some people, okay, whatever. But folk have been saying, okay, well, my name is Jerry. My name is Antoine. My name is Felicia. Because these people really know that there is a God.
Yes, God.
And for them to see somebody to receive them and actually tell them something like that, they are excited. Don't you know that the moment that you go in prayer, the Lord, you're letting the Lord know that I believe you, I trust you, I'm depending on you. This is a situation that I'm in that I can't solve myself. I'm not going to go to my brother. I'm not going to go to my sister. I'm going to go to you. So even by that person that's on the street that lets you know their name, that's letting you know that they believe in who you're talking about. So it's imperative, what, for us to live this life outside.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because I love them.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Now, we are his disciples. Uh-huh. All right? Now, we talked about loving one to another. Okay? Now, this was another commandment. Look what it says in the 34th verse. This commandment. This was an additional commandment to the 10.
Mm.
He's talking about love.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we know in the scripture. Now, watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Judas Iscariot.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If you look all of this, if you study this, this is when he was introducing who would betray him. Now, this was almost when Jesus was about to go to the crucifixion. Disciples didn't believe it. No, it's none of us, it's none of us. And he told them, you know the story, you shall deny me before the cock crow 3 times. Now, what happened with Judas Iscariot? After he saw what happened, he wept. He did his denying, read the story, read the scripture. He did his denying. And then we find out that he took his own life. He felt that bad that he hung himself.
Yes, he did.
But look at us now. Look at all of the commandments that God has given us. Look at what he has taught us how to live, what to do, what to say. And many of us have made bad mistakes. We have made bad choices. We didn't come out of our mother's womb saved, sanctified, and filled with the precious Holy Ghost.
That's right, that's right.
Some of us have made mistakes even while we were in the church. We have made mistakes even after we have claimed salvation. But what do we do? What do we do when we offend our brothers and our sisters? What do we do when we offend God himself? Oh, he loves us so much that he will give us another chance. So what do? Even in our sin, we get out of our sin and we say, Lord, forgive me. Help me in this area. Help me where I fall slack. Help me, Lord. Lift me up and let me stand. I want to stand on you, on Christ, the solid rock I stand.
Yeah.
All of the ground is what? Sand. So the love that God has for us, he continues to give us a second chance, a third chance, a fourth chance. So who are we if we say we love our brother, our sister, and they offend us, and we say, oh, I ain't talking to him no more. Come on, come on. I'm not speaking to him. I ain't got nothing to say. Thanksgiving come, and because something our family did to us 2,500 years ago that we can't even remember, we're not going to come and eat that turkey. Well, you a turkey. We got to learn to forgive one another. That's love. We got to learn to forget certain things. That's love. How many of y'all heard somebody get mad with somebody and say, well, I don't like you, but I got to love you?
Amen.
That ain't love. See, y'all quiet. Y'all must have said it. If you have to make an announcement like that, that's not love. You should be able to say, well, I don't even say I don't like your ways. That have nothing to do with it. Because somebody don't like your ways. No matter what you have done, I love you. Now, we don't have to be buddy-buddy and always going together and go this, that, and the third. But I still love you. Because there's something that's bigger than me. There's something that's bigger than you. That's something that's called Jesus. Look what Jesus did for us. You know,
yes.
Look what they did to him. Look how they spit on him. Look how they cursed him out. Look how they yanked his beard, punched him in his face. The Bible lets us know that even his passage, if you didn't know who he was, you wouldn't know who he was. Because he didn't even look like himself. But he still
Now, it's not for us to get on the cross. He already did that. But what can we do for one another to let everyone know that I love you? And what better way is it to draw people to Christ? Listen, I want you to serve this Jesus that I serve. He's all about love. No matter what you have gone through, no matter how much persecution you have gone through, no matter if your father, your mother have forsaken you, your sister, your brother, it doesn't matter. Jesus loves you.
Yes, he does.
He said in his word that I will never leave you nor forsake you. So what is this love we're talking about? The love of Jesus. It'll make you talk right.
Uh-huh.
It'll make you act right. It'll make you walk right. It'll make you treat your neighbor right. It'll make you treat the stranger right. The love. It's nothing like the Shekinah love of Jesus Christ. Look how Jesus demonstrated his love to God. He said, Abba, Father.
Abba, Father.
God, I love you. I adore you. I worship you. I praise you. You're magnificent. You're holy. You're beautiful. I love you. But if I tell the Lord that I love you, I got to tell Lord's people. And I got to show it. So that's what I want to talk about today. That's all it is. I love you. We stand and we say it all the time. I love you. But if we just show it, mama, just show it every day. You know you got a boss that gets on your nerves. But if you come in there with your Bible, he see your boy, you can't curse him out. You know, I heard something before, and I'm about to sit down, and it's so true. Someone, it was said a couple of times, said, you know why your job folk don't come to your church? You know why your family don't come to your church? Say, why? Because they see how you are out of church.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many souls that we can win, and there's so many out there that look at the church as a bunch of hypocrites. And they'll tell you straight to your face, why should I go to your church? Waste money putting on a suit. Then y'all have all type of offerings.
Amen.
Just for me to live the same way in there that I'm living out there.
Amen.
So we got to prove them wrong. We got to let them know, baby, we are standing for Christ. There is somebody that got Jesus on board.
Yes.
No matter what others are doing, others are saying, guess what? I'm operating in love. I'm operating in love. And if I love God the way that I said I love God, notice I said love, L-O-V-E. Not this nonsense that's on the radio talking about L-U-H. I love God. What's wrong with you? No, what's wrong with you? You're disrespectful. Talking about I love God. Call him Lordy, Lordy. He ain't your Lordy, Lordy. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes,
it's time for us to have some respect for God. It ain't about the money. It ain't about the money. People out there singing for the money. It's not about the money. Are you singing about the money or are you singing about the love?
Wait.
I thought that's y'all would be with me.
Whoa.
But I love the Lord. Do you love the Lord?
Yes. So good.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.